Good morning guys, welcome back to BioBuddy, and this is the second part of the circulatory system video, and I hope you have seen the first part. So guys, if you are seeing these videos and if you are liking them, kindly like, share and subscribe, right? It is mandatory. We are working hard for you. You need to do your bit, right? So let's just move forward with the second video of the circulatory system. In the system, we'll be talking about the hematocrit value, or the packed cell volume. It is also called as the packed cell volume. Our major concern in this video is that what is hematocrit value and what is the packed cell volume, right? So in this video, we will be talking about two things: composition of blood also and the hematocrit value also. So now let's move forward. I hope you have seen the previous videos of the respiratory system as well as the digestive system that I have posted, because they are very, very great and it consists of a lot of things which are not given anywhere. So you guys should definitely watch them and give it a read, give it a see. For example, if you think that there is some point which is going on too fast and you want it to be slow, so you can just pause on the video and you can directly just write it somewhere so that you can memorize it later on, right? So now let's quick start with our video. So this is hematocrit value, and it is also called as the packed cell volume. Now what do you mean? Hematocrit value, it basically represents the percentage of RBCs in the whole blood. That means in the previous video, if you must have seen, I had told you about that the blood is red in color, but that doesn't mean all it has is RBCs, right? It also has WBCs, it also has platelets, plasma, right? So all these different components of blood are there. So now we are talking about what is hematocrit volume. It is the total volume or the total amount of the RBCs which are present in the blood. It basically represents the total amount of RBCs which are present in the blood, right? So this is the estimated figure. In males it is 45% and in females it is 42%, right? This is the RBCs value. That means if you are having supposedly how much liter of blood, whatever may be the amount of blood that your body is having, out of that 8%, right, that 8% of the blood, that 45% and 42% in female, 45% in males, this is the RBC's value, right? I hope this is clear. Okay, now after this, this is the hematocrit value. Now let's move on to the composition of blood. In the previous video, I had told you about the composition of blood, the process of centrifugation. Right, in that process, I think there were three layers which we had talked about: the plasma, the buffy coat, and the last, in which the RBCs were clotted, they were present together. Right, in the middle layer, what was present? WBCs and the platelets. And in the first layer, the topmost layer, which is used for the sample testing, that is the plasma. That is the yellow transparent layer which is used for testing. Right, so in this video, you will be studying that there are two parts. One is the blood plasma and one is the cellular fraction, right? So the blood plasma, composition of blood, it's basically divided into blood plasma and cellular fraction. So now we are talking about the blood plasma. I have already told you, we have done the experiment about the blood plasma, that in blood plasma what is happening, it is a yellowish transparent layer which is present on the top and it is used for sample testing, right? Yes, we can trick it out with the help of dropper. So here also we are talking about blood plasma, which is the yellow transparent non-living fluid. It is a non-living fluid, right? So what happens? What is present inside this blood plasma? Why are we using it as testing? Why hum yahi ki use karte hain? Why can't we use some other things? Because it basically consists of all the blood proteins, right? So we will be talking about the blood protein number one, that is albumin. Albumin is blood protein one, then globulin, then fibrinogen, and then all the others which are present. Okay, so albumin is 54% of the total proteins or the total blood proteins which are present in the blood. Out of that, albumin is 54%, globulin is 38%, fibrinogen is 7%, and all the others, they are also making a part of it, and they are 1%. Is that clear? I hope you guys are clear till now that we are talking about the blood proteins which are present in the yellow transparent blood plasma. So what are the four types of proteins that we have studied? It is albumin, globulin, fibrinogen and others. So along with that, I have also written the percentages. Albumin is forming the 54%, globulin 38, fibrinogen 7, and the all others, they are forming just 1%. Okay, now let's move on to 91.5% is basically water. It is written here very clearly. Hope now you can see 91.5% is water and 1.5% there are gases, cations, anions and the waste products. So I hope till here it is very clear to all of you. I don't think any doubt should be there because I've mentioned everything very clearly. And waste products are also present inside the plasma. Now if we talk about the cellular fraction, right? Cellular fraction means the living part, the cells which are present inside the blood. Cells, jitne bhi cells hai, wo kiske under aayenge in the column cellular fraction. Right? So first is platelets. Ab kitna amount hoga platelets ka blood mein? 1.5 lakh to 4 lakh. This will be the platelet. Then RBCs, 48 to 54 million. I hope you know that the color of RBC is because of the hemoglobin pigment. Right? Hemoglobin pigment is present in case of the RBCs. That is why they are giving it a red colored or a pigmented color. 48 to 54 million RBCs. Then WBCs, 5,000 to 10,000. Okay? WBCs are the least. So what happens if during an infection, the infection is more, it is causing a more severe disease to your body, that means your body is unable to fight against the immunity. Your immunity is unable to fight for you. So what happens in that case? All these RBCs, the number lessens to 1000 to 900, 800. This is the range of the WBCs. It becomes so less that drastically your body loses the immunity. That death majorly happens in those cases because your body loses the ability to fight against that infection. Why? Because obviously the RBCs are being finished. Agar RBCs, WBCs nahi bachenge to fir aapki body ko immunity koi nahi de payega. Right. Next is WBCs and its types. WBC, for example, RBC is only of one type in human beings right now we are talking about. So, but in WBCs they have a variety aur sabka alag alag function hai. Right, so in WBC, the first one that we are talking about is neutrophils. I hope you can check the spellings online also because right now I have not written it very clearly. So you can just check it out. So neutrophils are forming about 60 to 70%, right, of the WBCs. Then comes lymphocytes. Lymphocytes are forming 20 to 25%. Then comes monocytes, 3 to 8%. Eosinophils, 2 to 4%. Basophils, 0.5 to 1%. And monocytes, see, lymphocytes, they are further divided into three parts: B cells, T cells and NK cells. NK cells for natural killer cells, B cells and T cells. This you will study further in the coming videos. So I hope this video is very clearly demonstrated for you, right? And very clearly I have explained in very clear words. So if you have any doubt, you can just comment down below and do not go without liking my video. Click on the subscribe button. Until then, take care, stay tuned for the next video, guys.